This is Rebecca from chemistryismyjam.com. This is Unit 3 about the periodic table. This unit is going to review the history of the periodic table. We'll look at the parts of the periodic table. We'll take a look at the differences between metals and nonmetals. We'll learn to draw valence dot diagrams, illustrate trends in the periodic table, and those trends will include ionization energy, electronegativity, and atomic size. Let's get started with the history of the periodic table. Early civilizations were aware of many of the common metals like silver and gold, but there was a large gap in time before new elements began to be discovered. During that time, not much scientific experimentation was taking place. It wasn't until 1669 when phosphorus became the first element since ancient times to be discovered. And it's an interesting story. Hennig Brand discovered phosphorus trying to turn human urine into gold. I'll put a link to an article about it in the description, but basically he was like burning human urine and trying to distill gold out of it. Move forward into the 1700s, and many of the elemental gases were beginning to be discovered. In the early 1800s, a lot of the common elements like sodium and calcium were discovered. And in the late 1800s, there was a lot of work going on surrounding the radioactive elements. We continue to discover new elements today. Scientists are working to synthesize some of the larger elements and fill in some of the gaps at the bottom of the periodic table. Chemistry has really exploded over the last couple of centuries. In that time, it became necessary to somehow organize these elements, and that's where the periodic table came into place. One of the first stabs at the periodic table is credited to John Newland in 1863. He arranged the elements by weight and then noticed that every 8 elements had similar properties. So he proposed the law of octaves, and this divided the elements into 11 groups. While chemists continue to recognize the number 8 as an important number in chemistry, these 11 groups are no longer sufficient to organize all the elements that we are now aware of. So the periodic table had to change some. Our modern periodic table is credited to 2 scientists, Dmitri Mendeleev from Russia and Lothar Meyer from Germany. These 2 scientists were working separately on the same idea. However, Mendeleev published his work first, so he receives the majority of the credit for the periodic table. Mendeleev was also able to use his periodic table to predict the properties of some elements that had not been discovered yet, which gave a lot of credibility to him within the scientific community. Mendeleev's periodic table arranged the elements according to atomic weight. The current periodic table arranges the elements according to atomic number. Even though they're arranged by different numbers, you will find very few differences in the order of the elements between Mendeleev's periodic table and the current periodic table. When he arranged these elements according to atomic weight, the groups that the elements fell into had similar properties. This allowed him to leave gaps in the table for elements that had not been discovered yet. He almost received the Nobel Prize for this work. Mendeleev's periodic table looked something like this, and you can see where he left these gaps that I've highlighted for elements that had not been discovered yet. He correctly predicted that gallium, scandium, and germanium should be discovered, and he left a space in the table for them. He took this a step further and predicted the properties of those elements. Here you can see what Mendeleev predicted for gallium in 1871. Gallium was not discovered until 1875, and its actual properties are listed here. Mendeleev predicted that gallium would have an atomic mass of 68. The actual atomic mass was 69.72, pretty close. He predicted a density of 6.0, the actual was 5.9. He predicted a low melting point. The actual is 29.78, which is not much above room temperature in Celsius, so that is a low melting point. He also made a prediction about how this element would react with oxygen. He said there would be two of this element for every three oxygens, which is spot on for how gallium reacts with oxygen. He also got the density of that compound correct and the solubility of that compound. Mendeleev's predictions about gallium were very accurate, and they were totally based on the patterns that he was seeing in the properties on his periodic table. This gave so much credibility and really validated Mendeleev's periodic table. I hope I've made the point that the periodic table is so much more than just a list of elements. Stick around as we look at the parts of the periodic table, and then some of the many predictions that a chemist can make about an element completely based on where it's located on the table.